Hey friends, did you know that you can bring a piece of Azure to you? This is an Azure Stack Edge. It's a Microsoft branded secure cloud managed appliance with edge storage and edge compute capabilities. It's hardware as a service. Dipti Pai is here to show me how it works today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday, and this is a very exciting episode because we're going to talk about Azure Stack Edge with engineer Dipti Pai. How are you?
I'm doing good, Scott. Thanks for having me on the show.
Oh, this is fantastic. I really like this because you're going to teach me all about a slice of the cloud in my house, in my business, in my data center. It's on premises.
Yep. So that's what Azure Stack Edge is, and that's what we'll be talking about today.
Fantastic.
So Azure Stack Edge is, you can think of them as specialized edge computing devices. So these are completely Azure managed. They come with hardware acceleration capabilities as well as network data transfer capabilities. So here I have like the portfolio of Azure Stack Edge. Like on the left, we see the Azure Stack Edge Pro, which is a 1U server, which you kind of mount onto a rack in your data center. It comes in two configurations. One of them has one NVIDIA Tesla 4 Tensor Core GPU, and the second one has two GPUs. And then on the right here, we have the rugged Azure Stack Edge devices. There is the Azure Stack Edge Pro R, which is a server class ruggedized device, which is meant to sort of operate in harsh environments. It comes with one GPU as well and has optional uninterrupted power supply. And then we have the Azure Stack Edge Mini R, which I think for a really small device, I think it really packs a punch because it comes with it's battery powered, it is lightweight, it is ultra portable, it has a Wi-Fi, and it just weighs about 7 pounds. So it's really meant to be sort of taken into the field to like the actual place where you do your edge computing.
Wow.
That's the Azure Stack Edge devices for you.
So if I understand correctly, when we say it's a piece of Azure in my house, it's not that I'm gonna SSH into them and treat them like a regular computer that I buy. They are running Azure, they're managed by Azure. I manage them in the Azure portal.
Yep. So you actually get these Azure Stack Edge devices as a complete hardware as a service from Microsoft. So you get real Azure quality, Azure security hardware that you can place in your on-premise environment. And it's a really hassle-free experience for the user because they simply pay as they go. And the ordering experience, et cetera, is also really straightforward. You just go to the Azure Stack Edge, you go to the Azure portal, you create an Azure Stack Edge resource. It sort of guides you through the ordering process. You get the box. If it's one of the rack-mounted server, you plug in the cables, the network. And then with minimal steps, you can project your on-prem device as an Azure resource. So it sort of makes it up it's a physical device that is in your network that you can touch and feel and see.
Wow.
But it actually gets projected as an Azure resource.
Wow. So if I have Azure virtual machines already, and I do, I can go into the Azure portal and I see them. If I have Azure VMs inside of Azure Stack Edge Pro in my local data center, I see those also?
Yep. So you see your Azure Stack Edge resource just like any other resource in the cloud.
Wow. Okay. So like you said, you go up and you make a resource and you go through this process. And as you create it, then you pay monthly and it shows up at your location. You can take it, if it's rugged, out into the woods or the mountains.
Yep.
or if you want, you can take it to here. So I actually got one. I got an Azure Stack Edge Pro right here. It's a lot bigger and more powerful than I thought it would be. It's very heavy. This is a 1U device. So look at the cool front of that. And you work on these, but do you ever touch them? Because it's so heavy.
They're actually in the lab stacked somewhere. So I've seen them, but I don't go and touch them on a regular.
You don't lift them up like this, yeah. Well, I do have a static around a static cord on my foot to make sure I don't break anything or shock anybody. But what do we have inside of this 1U device here?
So in terms of processing power, it has two Intel Xeon Cascade Lake CPUs. Each of them has 12 cores. So with hyperthreading, that is around 48 vCPUs.
Wow.
In terms of RAM, it has 8 16 gig RAM cards. That's a total of 128 gigs of memory. So it's like processing power and RAM wise, it's pretty beefy hardware to run your edge computing workloads.
Yeah, it's amazing. And I also noticed that there's a GPU up here.
Yep. So that is like the NVIDIA Tesla 4 Tensor Core GPU. Mm-hmm. So you can run all your AI ML models that you have right there on your edge computing location.
Mm-hmm. And then I also noticed in the front, if I take off the front model here, I'm going to just lift it up like this. And I'm just going to pop off the front. I've got lots and lots of storage here, and if I pop these open, it's just filled with SSDs. So there's a huge amount of storage as well.
Yep, so it actually has the configuration that you have there, which is the Azure Stack Edge Pro. Mm-hmm. It has five 1.6 terabyte NVMe, so that totals up to like 8 terabytes of raw capacity.
Wow, okay. And again, the great part about this just isn't any server blade that I treat like any server blade. It's a piece of Azure projected as Azure. Can you show me what that looks like in the portal?
Yep. Let's take a look. So here I have my Azure Stack Edge device that I have registered to the Azure Stack Azure portal. And I've actually gone ahead and configured compute already on this device. So what that does behind the scenes is it creates a Kubernetes cluster for you. So this Kubernetes cluster can actually be managed in one of three ways. You can either, when you configure compute, it actually creates an IoT edge device and associates the Azure Stack Edge device with IoT Edge. So if you're one of the customers who really love working with the IoT ecosystem and Azure IoT Edge in particular, then you can really use this as like it'll fit really well into your environment, and you'll be able to sort of process the data from your tons of IoT devices. And also it acts like a transparent IoT Edge gateway as well.
Wow.
So, yeah, that is the first way to manage. The second way to manage the Kubernetes cluster would be via Azure Arc. So when we create the Kubernetes cluster, it also has these Arc agents that are running on the Kubernetes cluster. So it gets projected as an Azure Arc resource. So any configuration data, so like all the capabilities of Azure Arc is something that you get inherently with the ASE. So, for example, Azure Arc has this capability to sort of associate configurations. So you can have like a GitHub repo that you create and then associate it with the Kubernetes cluster on the ASE. And you can develop like this entire GitOps pipeline where you sort of just do Git commits into this repo corresponding to your Kubernetes deployments. And that'll just get pulled down seamlessly and run on your Azure Stack Edge device.
That's really nice. So that means that people who are already familiar with Azure and they're using Azure in their workflows, in their developer workflows, it's a very natural way to get things on a device at the edge.
Yep, absolutely.
Okay, cool. So I can do it with Kubernetes. I can deploy modules and other things to it directly.
Yeah, so I mean, you can edge compute consists of two things in Azure Stack Edge. You can either deploy your own VMs. So there's like a lightweight version of ARM that runs on Azure Stack Edge. So you can deploy VMs using VM templates, Azure PowerShell, CLI. So you can do all of those things. And then you can also run your containerized workloads on the Azure Stack Edge. So you can think of like anything that sort of runs in a container can run on the Azure Stack Edge. So there are a number of Azure services like Azure Stream Analytics, Azure Functions, Azure Cognitive Services. If there is a Edge container version of it, then it can run on the Azure Stack Edge.
Very cool. All right. What else can we do here in the portal?
So I actually have a demo for you, which sort of uses Azure Cognitive Services, and we've built like a model which sort of reaches out to Azure Cognitive Services whenever you drop a file onto like a local share. So I can show that to you.
Let's do it.
So As you can see here, I've created two shares. So Azure Stack Edge has this capability of creating a storage, and that storage is actually residing on your Azure Stack Edge device. And like you can consume data using one of three protocols, either SMB, NFS, or using REST APIs. So here I've created these two shares and associated them with like an SMB share. And then here you see that these are use for compute is enabled. What this does behind the scenes is it creates persistent volumes corresponding to these shares so that you can actually mount these shares into your container. And then whenever you read from or write into these shares, that is actually all the way it goes into the SMB backend.
Excellent. Okay, so it's volume mounting that we're familiar with as it relates to Azure storage, all running Correct. On the Stack Edge.
All running on the Stack Edge, right.
Cool.
And then we also have this storage account here. So as you can see, the local share, it doesn't have a storage account associated with it. So all the data that you write onto the local share is all completely local to the appliance. And then we have the cloud share, which is associated with a storage account of type blob. So whenever you write any data onto the cloud share, it actually automatically gets synced back to this Azure storage account.
You know, what's really nice about this is it really showcases how important privacy is, and that there are workloads that you love Azure, you want to use Azure, but it makes more sense for that to be happening locally. And it's extremely explicit, isn't it, about what's local and what's not. And, you know, you can do really smart ML things and really smart AI work, and only what you want to leave the cloud leaves the cloud and it stays on your Stack Edge.
Yep, absolutely. So you can choose whether you want a local share, you want a cloud share, and that's completely up to how you want to sort of deploy these applications and use it.
Very cool.
So what we'll do next is we'll just go here and then just take a look at like the modules that are currently running on IoT Edge on the Kubernetes platform. So we have Edge Agent and Edge Hub running. We'll go ahead and add a new module. Let's give this a name. So the app that I'm running is an object detection app. And I've actually already pushed the Docker container corresponding to this application to an Azure container registry. Mm-hmm. And here I'm mapping like a local share. So the app logic has been written such that anytime you drop a share onto this local share, it actually uses that as the input. And then any processing that it does, it actually writes the processed output into this output share. Mm. And then here we'll create a trigger. So what this does internally, this is Azure Stack Edge software. So anytime a file is dropped onto this input share, it actually sends a message to Edge Hub saying that a new file is available. And it also sends the relative file path of this new file that was added. Cool. So now that the new file has got added, your module can then sort of work on this new file, run its app logic, and then, you know, it can do cool stuff.
You know, the thing that I just had a moment there when you did that and you deployed it, I thought it was coming here. So I turned myself to my Azure Stack Edge and I said, and now it's getting the update from you. But if I had this plugged in, that's exactly what would have happened.
Yep. It's actually running on a device exactly like that.
Okay, cool. So I'm going to pretend. So you've just put that module here. It's running on my Edge. I have local storage, and then the output was the cloud. So maybe I have IoT devices or cameras that are feeding into this on the local storage. It sees that it triggers and then it does something.
Yep, absolutely.
Okay, cool.
So let's just refresh the screen. And then we see that the app that we added is already in a running state. So before we test this out, I just wanted us to take a look at the cloud share. So this is the storage account associated with the cloud share that we added to the module. So we'll refresh this and we'll just confirm that currently there are no files in this particular cloud storage account. And then here I have, so as we saw earlier, these file shares, they are using SMB protocol. So I've just mounted the local share and as well as the cloud share using mm-hmm. SMB on my desktop. Okay. And then here I have some sample images that I'm just using for testing. So I'll just go ahead and drop that in the local share. Mm-hmm. And then we can just take a look at the image. So here we have like a few cars. And this is actually just a Windows kitchen, which has a few appliances. So while I was talking, we saw here that the image is actually already processed and we have like some results. It's actually detected a bunch of appliances in the image. And it also prints like a nice summary. Like here it says, the summary is a person is sitting at a table using a laptop. So that, and then similarly with the racetrack pic, it just saw that there are a few cars in the image. And then it printed out a summary saying that it's a close-up of a car with like 93% confidence.
Wow. And see, what's so cool about this is, again, that local compute. You have that model deployed from Azure and the Azure portal. It shows up on the edge. The work happens on the edge, and you get to control where it comes and goes.
Yep, absolutely. Actually also go back to like the storage account that we had. And then if I refresh it, we see that the same contents which were there in the cloud share, they've all actually got seamlessly synced to the cloud. So you really didn't have to do anything. You just put it in the output share and it's available for like, so like in a real world scenario, you can think about when you're running your ML models, etc. These models need to be continuously retrained and tuned for the results to sort of become like improve in quality, right? So you can send maybe interesting results, maybe you can send entire data sets up to Azure for like that retraining. And when that is happening, all of your edge workloads continue to run uninterrupted on the Azure Stack Edge.
Very cool. Now, I'm lucky to have one of these, but I have to send it back after this. They sent it to me only for the show. So for people who think that I have a piece of the edge, I actually have to give it back. But I found something really cool that you might be excited about that you may not actually know about, even though you work on it. Have you heard about the Microsoft Hardware Experience application for Android and iPhone?
I have not.
It's super
cool.
Tell
me all about it.
It is super cool. So the deal is you go in here and it has a list of the different Azure Stack Edge products, which you might think, why is that interesting? I can get that you know, on the web. Well, what this does is it lets you do an augmented reality view of that that product so you can see what it would look like in your data center. So I'm just going to take a moment and I'm going to share my screen and let's see what that looks like. So this is the Microsoft Hardware Experience app. So I'm going to take the Azure Stack catalog, and you showed us a Edge Pro. I'm going to pick a Stack Edge Pro R, the ruggedized version. And it says the product specs, and I can learn all about it. Or I can say launch AR. And look at this. We'll pick my floor. So there's my floor, my messy floor. I can see it in my space.
Wow, you have both the Azure Stack Edge Pro as well as the Azure Stack Edge Pro R.
Huh? See, there's the there's the fake one, and there's the real one.
I really can't tell the difference.
It's just, yeah, it's exactly like you never know. And I can go inside very close and see all the cool ports and see that in my own space. Isn't that fun?
Yep, that looks amazing.
I thought you'd get a kick out of that. So everybody gets to look at the Azure Stack and enjoy the Azure Stack, which is pretty cool. And then can you show us the website where we learn more about this?
Yeah, so here's where you can learn all about Azure Stack Edge. It's our documentation. You can see the use cases, the capabilities, the concepts, and just how to, you know, have fun with your Azure Stack Edge.
Fantastic. I want to get one of these right away. I have to give this one back, but I have virtual ones to play with the Microsoft Hardware Experience. I'm learning all about Azure Stack Edge Compute. Thank you so much for spending time with us here on Azure Friday.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it. Watch more Azure Friday.